All right, next up, Tia Bethea, and she is going to tell us what the digital divide looks like here in the Triangle.
A couple of years ago, around this time of year, a young man in Southeast Raleigh was standing near a nonprofit under a streetlight, minding his business. A few cars passed beside him, and one called the police because they were a bit concerned about why this young man was standing there. And the officer came and walked up to the young man and said, "What are you doing, kid?" And he said, "My homework." He was standing by this nonprofit because there was Wi-Fi and he had easy access to it. And he could sit there using his smartphone to do his homework because he didn't have access. Now, I appreciate this young man's gumption, and I applaud him for standing there doing that, but this should not be the reality in our town. This should not be how we address the digital divide in our community. And I describe the digital divide as a gap between those who have quality access to internet, to devices, and who understand how to use them compared to those who don't. Now, the internet is a resource that we all know that is scarce in some neighborhoods and abundant in others. So what does this really look like for us? 7 out of 10 teachers assign homework that requires kids to get on the internet every single night. However, 1 out of 3 kids has no access to home, has no access to internet when they get home. And students who have access to the internet at home typically have graduation rates that are 6 to 8 percentage points higher than those who don't. Additionally, 80% of Fortune 500 companies, including McDonald's and Walmart, require you to apply online. And 72% of those on the internet have looked online for healthcare information. So what does that mean? For us locally, in the Triangle, 13.6% of residents don't have access to the internet at home. And when you dig a little bit deeper, 17.6% of dorm residents and 16% of Raleigh residents have no access at home. More importantly, if you look at people making less than $35,000 a year, 35% of those people can't get connected. And people ask me all the time, but what about smartphones? Everybody has a smartphone. Raise your smartphone, right? Everybody is excited, like, oh, you are connected. But let's be clear. Nearly one half of smartphone dependent Americans have to cancel their service because they cannot afford it every year. And we can do better than that. Our community is better than that. That's why we're in this room together, because we want to build on this innovation, but we need to bring everyone with us. We need to bring all these unique brains and ideas together, and so we can do better. So, quickly, I want to tell you a story about this guy. His name is Jimmy, and this is how we can do better. Jimmy is a resident of the Durham Housing Authority, one of their neighborhoods called McDougal Terrace, and I met him this summer along with 14 other residents from the neighborhood of over 300 units, so thousands of people that live in this neighborhood. And 14 of them signed up for a wonderful program led by Triangle Literacy Council, Crandon Institute, and sponsored by Google Fiber. And in this program, they have 4 weeks of digital literacy training. And I sat beside Jimmy the first day. And Jimmy had no clue how to turn on a computer. He didn't know what a mouse was. And so we walked him through this. And I came back at graduation, and Jimmy grabbed me. And Jimmy had a big smile on his face, just like he does in that picture. And he grabbed his wife, and she was excited too. And Jimmy said, "I got a job." Jimmy got a job, so we're really excited about that. And Jimmy attributes that to being able to learn how to use a computer. He was able to go to the library for the first time alone and get on a computer. He signed on online, applied for a job, and he's working now. And he credits this to being able to get connected. So I challenge everybody in this room, we're all passionate about something. And if you really look at those issues, at this center point, is access. So let's do what we can to make this better. Thank you.